Good evening.
Good evening.
Let me welcome all of you to the church, and on behalf of the church and the musicians, I want to thank you for coming. I would remind you that we will be meeting here again Sunday at 11. Join our hearts in prayer. Lord, we pray for your blessing upon us. We give you thanks for Christmas. We pray that you would touch our hearts and that this service would be meaningful for all. In Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
There are about 10,000 people here right now. So thank you for joining us live or on Facebook. So I have to tell you a few things about me. My name is Randy Freeling. I'm the director of music here and the organist. My degree is really in piano performance. So all my degrees are. So I learned organ on my own, and you'll hear that tonight. And I also learned conducting on my own. But I had a really great conductor friend that said it's easy and all of you can do this. It's floor, door, window, ceiling. Floor, door, window, ceiling. And, you know, y'all can do this. Don't practice while we're doing this. So I had several people say, why did you pick a Wednesday night at 7 p.m.? Well, for the 10,000 people here, I want you to join the choir, the Chancel Choir, which meets at 7 on Wednesday nights, and I see you're all free. That is so nice. So next we hear from the Chancel Choir, and you'll want to join us Wednesday nights at 7 p.m. for rehearsals. died on Christmas Eve, and were met by St. Peter at the pearly gates. In honor of this holy season, St. Peter said, you must each possess something that symbolizes Christmas to get into heaven. The first man fumbled through his pockets and pulled out a lighter. He flicked it on. It represents a candle, he said. You may pass through the pearly gate, St. Peter replied. The second man reached into his pocket and pulled out a set of keys. He shook them and said, they're bells. St. Peter said, you may pass through the pearly gates. The third man started searching desperately through his pockets and finally pulled out a pair of women's glasses. St. Peter looked at the man with the raised eyebrow and asked, and just what do those symbolize? The man replied, they're carols. So it's your turn to stand up and sing a Christmas carol. Please join us. Thank you. coming up to Christmas, and Johnny asked his mom if he could have a new bike. She told him the best idea would be to write Santa Claus. But Johnny, having just played a vital role in the school nativity play, said he would prefer to write the baby Jesus. So he went to his room and wrote, "Dear Jesus, I have been a very good boy and would like to have a bike for Christmas." But Johnny wasn't very happy when he read it over. So he decided to try again. And this time he wrote, "Dear Jesus, I'm a good boy most of the time and would like a bike for Christmas." He read it back and he wasn't happy with that one either. He tried a third version. "Dear Jesus, I could be a good boy if I tried hard and especially if I had a new bike." He read that one too. But he still wasn't satisfied. So Johnny decided to go out for a walk while he thought about a better approach. After a short time, he passed a house with a small statue of the Virgin Mary in the front garden. He crept in. He stuffed the statue under his coat and hurried home and hid it under his bed. Then he wrote this letter. "Dear Jesus, if you want to see your mother again, you better give me a new bike." Just so you know, Pastor Mike tells me to always tell the truth, so these are true stories.
Thank you.
perfect playing Care of the Bells, and that was the cue for the bells they're going to play now.
Thank you.
So I have to tell you, our spring concert, somebody in the audience just blurted out, "Why are there no men in the handbell choir?" So guess what we got? Two men. Handbell choir meets Wednesdays at 4:30. Next time our concert will be at 4:30, so I can see who's free at that time. There's good news and bad news. The preacher announced from the pulpit, "I have good news and bad news. The good news is we have enough money to retire our mortgage of the church." Sigh of relief went through the congregation. "The bad news is it's still in your pockets." So this is a free concert, but we do have offering plates in the back. If you have, you know, a checkbook in that pocket or something you want to get rid of, and just make it out to the music department. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So this morning, I baked a cake so that you all can be at a reception. I baked a big sheet cake all by myself. And you need to eat every bit of it, all 10,000 of you. I really have them going here on Facebook. They have not a clue. Because we don't have cameras that can turn around and pan, but you all look great. So we have a reception following this concert in Beery Hall. So please join us and meet the musicians. At a monastery high in the mountains, the monks have a rigid vow of silence. Only at Christmas, and only by one monk, and only with one sentence, is a vow allowed to be broken. One Christmas, Brother Thomas is allowed to speak, and he says, "I like the mashed potatoes we have with the Christmas turkey." And he sits down. Silence ensues for 365 days. The next Christmas, Brother Michael gets his turn, and he says, "I think the mashed potatoes are lumpy, and I hate them." Once again, silence for 365 days. The following Christmas, Brother Paul rises and said, "I am fed up with this constant bickering." True story. So next we have an organ piece. This is by a Canadian composer, Denis Bedard. "Bring a Torch, Jeanette Isabella." And hopefully you can watch my feet a little bit. It's kind of fun. It's not really fun for me, but it's fun for you to watch.
I put a big score up there so I don't have to look at that.
Thank you.
So for me, it's not really Christmas till I hear, "Oh, Holy Night."
Oh, holy night, the
So the choir has three more selections, but I just want to make sure you know you're all invited Christmas Eve, which is December 24th, 7 p.m. here at the sanctuary. We will have the choirs with us and the Orlando Brass, so we hope you can join us. Also, there's a reception where I baked a cake, so I hope you join us following this concert. Thank you for being here tonight.
Oh,
you know, this is what we usually do on Sunday mornings.
Thank you. seeing you. Hey, Fred. You doing okay? Good, good. I know. Yeah. Oh.